Good morning. I'd like to welcome you to the Berks Community Action Program on BCTV. I'm Jodi Readinger, BCAP's Community Relations Coordinator. We are live today on Tuesday, September 6th here in the BCTV studios. Our topic today is we're going to talk about the Front and Schiller Playground, and I am pleased to have, after a long absence, back as my guest, our Executive Director, Larry Berringer.
Well, thank you, Jodi. It's been a long absence, but I'm glad to be back. Talk to our viewers that tune in for our monthly telecast. And we have some exciting new initiatives going on into 2016 and 17. And I'm just pleased to be here to talk about them. But before we do that, I want to give our viewers an overview of some of our programs, because, you know, at the end of the state fiscal, when we get into July, August, and September, there's a lull in service delivery between the end of last year's state fiscal, which was 2015-16, and the beginning of this year's state fiscal, which is 2016, all the way to June 30th of 2017.
You mean they don't do that so we can take a vacation when the work slows down a little bit?
No, unfortunately, I was reading an article in today's paper that says most professional people that are dedicated to their jobs, as we are, rarely take vacations and sometimes go a year without taking any vacation days. And I said, I think I just had that conversation with Jodi. Right. But that being said, it's a great time of the year. I'm always well pleased to come on in September and give the overview, specifically some of the more tangible programs that we have, such as rental assistance. And we're taking applications. If you're on a waiting list, we'll be calling you to come in. Funding should be here any day now, and we're going to start to process those applications to get people much needed services. Also, we have a request in with the state of Pennsylvania through the Department of Community and Economic Development to do some more utility assistance this year.
Fantastic.
So I'm happy about that. If we can pay some electric bills, some water bills, some of the essential services, of course, not cable. So you would not be able to see us here on this great BCTV network if you're in the rears, but we will do utility, we will do electric, we'll do water, we'll do gas, things like that. That's all good stuff coming up. But that being said, for all of our services, when in doubt, give us a call. The number's on the screen, 376-6571 here in the 610 area code. Give us a call and just inquire. We have a very friendly staff. We have very professional people at the reception desk.
Yes,
you can call for me personally. You can call for Jodi. Information referral is our middle name. When in doubt, somebody at BCAP will help you. We'll let you know what the status of the program that you need is. And if you have any ideas, thoughts, feelings, if you want to volunteer, if you want to do community service, if there's a problem in your neighborhood, and we're going to talk about this, if you have a playground, a park, something that needs attention, give us a call. We'll get that information to the right people. We'll form the team here in Reading and Berks County, and we'll make action happen in your community. Jodi?
Okay, now he set me up for a bait. Can I fill those shoes?
Oh, absolutely. There's no doubt.
We have a new project. It's fall's coming. Mm-hmm. We've got a lot of stuff going on. And for a couple months, maybe about a year or two, we've been talking about the Front and Schiller Playground and trying to get the city interested, and the residents are already involved, and they've come to us and say, you know, we need to do something about this. So we're going to talk about the Front and Schiller Playground today. I have a little bit of PowerPoint and some pictures. What's great about this project is it's a neighborhood-driven project. You know, Larry said we can help organize things and all that. I'm coming in, and there's so much groundwork already done. It's like we're doing a community meal, and all I got to do is make the dessert and plate it up.
Yes.
So I have to give the neighborhood residents credit, and that's Larry's dual role today. As a resident of that neighborhood growing up, he's here to talk about the needs of the community. But the community is definitely working together to keep a safe area for residents to relax and play. Little background on Front and Schiller. It's located at Front and Schiller Streets in Reading 6th Ward. It's what's known as a pocket park. It's 0.68 acres, according to the Reading Recreation website. The conversations I've had with the city, the playground equipment was last renovated about 14 years ago. So it's had some attention. It's got basketball courts, it's got playground equipment, it's got swings, and it's got a small pavilion. And I went over there a couple weeks ago and I took a whole bunch of pictures. And you know, working in the city and around the city for 20-some years, I kind of expected to find a pretty trash-laden, dilapidated playground with lots of graffiti and stuff like that. That's not what I found. I was well pleased. The neighborhoods really keep an eye on it. I was there for about 5 minutes with my little iPad taking pictures before somebody came over and said, "Are you the lady from BCAP?" Thank goodness I had my hat on.
Right.
But they're definitely a neighborhood-involved community. So the Front and Schiller Playground is a city-owned playground. It's maintained by the Recreation Commission, Reading Recreation Commission. It's got climb on equipment for the children, some playground equipment, kids let off steam. It's got swings for the kids. It's got a pavilion for neighborhood use. There's my minivan. It's got basketball courts, trash cans, and fencing around the playground. It's in a nice wooded area. You don't realize till you get into some of these lesser known sections of the city. I'm very guilty of coming into the city, staying on Penn Street, Washington Street, Court Street, and going back home. But there's some really nice wooded areas. It's a very nice wooded park. It's cool in the summertime.
Absolutely. It has some tremendous trees. And Reading is known for that. Years back, we were like Tree City
USA.
Right. Exactly. With our love for trees.
We're showing our age.
Yes, exactly. And growing up on that playground as a child, as Jodi had alluded to, on that playground, I spent most of my days as a youth. There were even more trees down on the western edge, which subsequently were taken down because they had gotten too big or diseased or whatnot. But there are still beautiful trees that line Front and Schiller Playground. And what we want to do is, as we move forward, you know, we want to put some assets back in there. We want to do some redevelopment. And when I say we, I say us as a team member. It's not a BCAP thing. The Public Works, I'd like to give a shout out to their director, Ralph Johnson, who does a tremendous job. Neil Namath, who got right on board when we brought this to their attention.
Cindy DeGroote.
Lori Tademy, who's a resident there, a lifelong resident who I had known my whole life as a child growing up on that playground. I'd like to just say a tremendous effort for taking the initiative, and we need more individual involvement in these neighborhoods, because these are our communities, these are neighborhoods, and as you look across the national medium, you look across on what's going on in Chicago or LA or Philadelphia or whatnot, we sometimes tend to lose sight that 99% of the people that live in these neighborhoods are good, hardworking, honest people who want quality of life and want community assets. Do we have crime? Do we have other adverse social conditions? Yes, we do. But it's a small percentage that make life unbearable for large sections of our community as we look across the nation. And it's our job and our commitment, right, to do what we can for our neighbors in need, right? We will mobilize, we will take action, and this is just a tremendous effort by the city, by people in the community, by other not-for-profit organizations coming together in a team effort, right, to get something done to improve quality of life for the hardworking people of our city.
And you raise a great point, because when the project was first brought to me and you first started talking about it, I looked into it and said, okay. But when I heard that the residents are going out there and cleaning it up themselves, there's a gentleman that painted the lines on the basketball courts himself, that they're providing their own nets for the basketball hoops because he and his sons play out there. That's what got me enthusiastic about it. And then going out there and seeing, and the picture we just had, there's a business actually across the street. And that gentleman, you know, came over, talked to me that day when we were there and said, anything we can do to help, too. NHS has a building that, if it backs up against the playground.
Yeah, I believe there's a community garden there.
There's so many resources over there and so many people that are willing to help out. This can just be a fantastic project and
absolutely,
a great community
absolutely.
Effort and something we can be proud of as a city and a community.
And we have some faith-based organizations there that surround that playground. Some businesses, like you said, I think an eatery, the House of Good Food, is across the street. So it's a viable neighborhood. It has lifelong residents. My mother still lives one block up. My sister still lives a block up. We're born and raised there. So that's not why we're doing the initiative there. It was a community in need, and of course, that's what we do.
Right. And I do find in my travels a lot of people, as we talk about what's going on with BCAP, and I mention this, I grew up in that area. Mm-hmm. I grew up on West Green Street. So there's a lot of people that are in the community that grew up in that area and have a fondness for the Front and Schiller Playground. And it's something that our kids really need.
Absolutely, so, absolutely.
Let's go back to our pictures. We got the wooded area. Where am I at? We've got some nice playground equipment. You know, it's a place to have fun and be a kid. I grew up in the suburbs without sidewalks areas. And we never had, I didn't have a neighborhood playground. So this, to me, is cool. A great place for your kids to go to. But, you know, when we started looking into it, the neighborhoods had definite concerns. They had concerns about the trash in the park.
Mm-hmm.
They had concerns about the repairs that were needed to the playground equipment. Definitely illegal activities in the evenings.
And one of the things I wanted to do, because I did make an observation there, is lighting. When we look at the illegal activities in the evening, mm-hmm. a lot of that, I think, can be abated if we get proper lighting there back on the
And there is some lighting in place that we'll show later on.
Okay.
And the city is aware of it. They were looking into whether or not it was the neighborhood, the neighbors that were concerned about the light shining in their bedroom windows at night, or what needed to be done to make that operable. There's a lack of seating. You know, if you bring your kids to the playground, you really don't want to stand there for an hour while they're running around. The idea is to tire them out and you relax a little bit.
Exactly.
So the city definitely is looking at benches and things like that and safety issues. And there also was, I don't know what I did here. There also was a concern about people not curbing their dogs. So when we go back now and look at the playground again, I mean, you've got a nice playground, but there are areas that need to be fixed. And the city has been alerted to these. The mayor's on board. Public Works is on board, Cindy DeGroote, CDBG. So we're real excited about what's going on. There was a water feature in there, and now there's an indentation that floods when it rains.
Mm-hmm.
There's some of the protective covering on the ground cover around the playground equipment, some of the shock-absorbing stuff. Needs to be, has pieces
missing.
Yeah,
and I'm not really sure with the life span on that type of stuff, because as we move around the city and we look for projects to task organize or, you know, maybe get private funding or you know, funding from the city or the county or the state, for that matter, what we try to do, we know resources are limited. So, you know, you want to stretch the lifespan of the apparatus as far as you can go, but clearly, when we looked at this apparatus, it's at the end of its lifespan.
Well, and we discussed that in Public Works, and these pictures are maybe about a month old.
Right,
so Public
right.
Works may have come out and done some of these things that needed to be done. There are pieces of playground equipment that are missing. There should be a slide here. There's some sharp edges
right,
that are potentially
right.
harmful.
And, you know, when you're talking about the little children,
right.
Okay, you know, that it just makes it, you know, non-conducive for what they want
right.
to do, because you can't have them with sharp edges around the play area.
Right. There's a piece of wood that was placed in as a temporary fix that's a little bit of a danger. There's, you know, obviously some trash dumping,
mm-hmm.
which happens all over the place, happens in my backyard too.
Yeah, and we've been fighting that collectively throughout the city. You know, the good thing about it is individuals from neighborhoods, mm-hmm. not just city, you know, the Public Works Department or whatnot, it's not their sole responsibility, because we're a team. Right,
mm-hmm.
residents, city workers, governmental employees, right, and us in the not-for-profit, we have to do it together.
Right.
To curb this illegal dumping and trash pickup.
Right, and the neighbors do come in on a regular basis. The homes facing the playground, gentlemen's always out cleaning up. They're picking up trash and stuff. There's some paint needed on the playground equipment. You know, it's showing some wear. It's
mm-hmm.
been there for 14 years.
Right.
It gets some use, so it's showing some wear. There's paper trash and animal refuse. And realistically, while there is trash, this is much better than some I've seen.
Much better than I expected.
And
again, you know, I want to commend the residents there at Schiller Street, the back of Buntwood Street, Rosenthal Street, Pear Street, that come up and you know, pick up the trash.
Right.
And of course, the city as well.
Right. And then there's a little bit of it. We talked about the wood area. This tree, to my eye, looks a little bit dead.
Mm-hmm.
And it's endangering the pavilion, obviously, homes and parked cars. And that's a huge issue, because when I talk to the city about it, they have to have somebody come out and officially say it's dead. They can't just take my word for it.
Mm-hmm.
and then go through all the tree removal issues. It's not just like in my backyard where my husband gets out the chainsaw
and
we're
done.
Care
of it, right.
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 The lighting is there, but it's inoperable. And, you know, I have every confidence that the city is going to work on that and use those existing fixtures to make it operable again. Oops, I should have flipped that. There's only one bench in the playground.
And somebody told me that some of the residents had had assembled the benches because at one time there were like none.
Yeah.
So that's definitely a consideration. We need more seating and more.
And the city is looking at that with the CDBG application. So there's some broken equipment that's not being used, and I don't know what the point of this one is. I've seen it in different playgrounds. I guess you throw the balls through and you try to figure out which one is coming out. But there's some broken equipment that's not being used. And obviously the warning signs that no one really listens to.
Right, and spray graffiti over.
Right. So what's happened, you know, there's some real positive things. The neighbors have taken action. They've cleaned up the park on a regular basis. In April, when we had the Great American Cleanup, they organized a cleanup in conjunction with that. They had some publicity, the newspaper, the mayor came out. And they on their own accord brought out food, they brought out drinks, they brought out music. So they're doing what they can to take care of the playground and make it a better place, but they're also meeting everybody else in their neighborhood and making it a safer place to live. They take care of the courts, the basketball courts. Now, I got to give kudos to Reading Rec and Daphne out there, and her maintenance department. They have gone out, they've put the nets up this year, they've put the swings up. But before that, the residents were painting the lines. They were
right.
Providing the nets themselves. And it shouldn't have to be that way, but I'm so glad we have people in the city that are doing that. And the residents, everybody at City Hall knows them. They contact City Hall, they contact Reading Rec, they contact the police, they contact the mayor's office about their concerns.
Right.
And we've had the discussion, they want everything fixed tomorrow. Unfortunately, it doesn't work that way. But, you know, the city is well aware of what's going on, so they're listening.
Yeah, absolutely, and they're going to take action. And like you said, you know, in the perfect world, we could come out and we could do this overnight. We could task organize it and we just move on, you know, and have the playground, you know, beautiful forever. But there are timelines, there are funding issues, there are manpower issues. There are things that are scheduled, you know, years in advance,
mm-hmm.
right, that have to run their course, and everybody has to take their turn. So I commend the city. We've been doing this for a long time. We've been in these neighborhoods for a long time, and I am well pleased that this initiative, that this city, right, is moving this playground forward. And there are other, you know, initiatives in the city. I think the Henny Gilmore Foundation,
right.
I was just reading, they did Essex Playground. I commend them for their efforts. They, of course, did Barbie's a few years back. So it's a consolidated effort of, like I said, you know, the city, various not-for-profits, neighborhood committees and groups, and you know, individual citizens that are just taking their time and effort to do this stuff. So we in the city of Reading should be proud of our residents and the people that make up these neighborhoods.
And this is a perfect example of how City Hall's listening,
mm-hmm.
and you really can make a difference in your neighborhood.
Absolutely. You know, there was a time when people say, you know, why should I bother? Why should I call City Hall? Why should I call the Rec Commission? Why should I call BCAP? You know, nobody's listening. Nobody's doing anything. But those days, I am so pleased to announce that those days are over. We understand, you know, forming coalitions,
mm-hmm.
forming committees, everybody getting involved, building the team, right, municipal, private, not-for-profit, and getting things done. And that's the way we share resources, and that's the way we accomplish things.
Right. And we still have many people to bring to the table.
Oh,
yeah,
absolutely.
We're just setting the stage and,
absolutely.
Working slowly. So the positive response, you know, the playground's been targeted for renovation using CDBG funding
mm-hmm.
by the city. Now, that needs to formally be approved by City Council in November.
Right.
I'm working on City Council members as we speak.
Right.
But definitely it's something the city's looking forward to. They've got some great plans for the area, and we're looking to have the residents come out and give us some more ideas of what's going on. Reading Recreation Commission has provided nets for the basketball hoops, swings for the swing sets, regular grass maintenance, other support.
Yes.
BCAP's got involved to bring interested parties together and make repairs a reality. So.
And we have, we're going to have a community day there, I believe, aren't we?
Yes, we are.
All right.
Yep, next steps. The city's presenting the plan for CDBG money for City Council in November. If approved, and we have every belief that it will be. Improvements could begin in the spring. Reading Recreation Commission is providing maintenance supplies and support for the playground. The neighborhood residents are organizing and learning how they can make a difference. And community partners like BCAP are becoming interested in sharing expertise on improving the area. And we've got
Alrighty.
A fall festival. We're going to do it at Front and Schiller Playground on October 29th, which is the last Saturday in October. We're going to do a cleanup for the playground. We're going to have, we've got a nice little flyer there.
All right.
We're going to do a cleanup. It's going to start at 10 a.m. And then we're going to have a community fair. We're still trying to get all that organized, but definitely there will be some food involved.
Oh, that's my area of expertise, food.
There will be some games for the kids. We're going to try to get some information from community organizations. If you're interested in helping out, let me know. BCAP 610-376-6571. You can hit me up on our Facebook page, the Berks Community Action Program. Email is jredinger@bcapberks.org. All that kind of stuff. But we're excited about this.
Oh, extremely
excited. Our staff is getting involved, and fall's a very busy time. We've got a lot of stuff going on the weekends.
It is, but it's absolutely my favorite time of the year. It's like a renewal. We seem to undertake a lot of community initiatives, right? Morale gets high. Everybody, you know, wants to jump in. So I'm very well pleased.
Yeah. So any questions, you know, give me a call. Sometimes it's better to email or leave me a message. I'm out doing this kind of stuff a lot. And my time in the office sometimes is limited. But we are really looking forward to what's going on in Front and Schiller.
Oh, yeah.
I'm excited about it. I've been in this game long enough to see neighborhood initiatives come and neighborhood initiatives go.
But anyway, you will be out and about in the community, and people can recognize you now because we've upped the ante, so to speak, here at BCAP, right? We went away from tradition, right? We got some bright colors here. Jodi is actually modeling one of our new T-shirts. So you'll see us at Front and Schiller Playground. We have the bright orange with our logo and stuff. We also have the what seems to be the newer color for municipalities and emergency workers and whatnot. We got what is it like?
They glow green.
Yeah, all right.
I so no longer need a nightlight because I have my T-shirt right, in the bedroom.
Right, and then we also have the last version. This is a special edition of version here, the camouflage. And when you see us out in these neighborhoods, like we're going to be at Front and Schiller Playground, we'll be handing some of these out to our volunteers and the people that come out to do community service and whatnot as a way to say thank you for your support and participation.
Oh, and we are very lucky to have a lot of different things that we can hand out, some things that we've purchased ourselves, some books that we've purchased,
we've got through partners, and
craft kits and things like that. So we'd love to hand out stuff. We try to do it all over the place. Less I have to worry about storing in my office. But we like to be out and about. You have any questions, you're more than welcome to come up and ask us. If we can't answer it for you that day, we'll give you the phone number, whoever in our agency can, because things change often. I don't know all the rules for all the programs.
Exactly. And when in doubt, just give us a call at the main office at BCAP. And for those of you who are tuning in and maybe been on vacation, we have moved. Our new address is 645 Penn Street. So we're right on Penn Street, right next to the Doubletree. Easy to find. We're on the third floor. So you give us a call, 610-376-6571. Come on in. Come to the reception area. Or if you see us on the streets, whatever. We're at your service.
And I didn't bring a picture of that, but we have a brand new red van that you can't miss.
Yes, you can't miss our new wheels.
We're like the Rainbow Coalition.
Yeah,
red van. Orange shirts, green shirts.
Right, so you'll see us out and about in the community, and it's a new year, a new BCAP, doing old things. And I guess it's about time to give the snappy close, Jodi.
Well, definitely, I'd like to thank BCTV for having us here today. Larry Berringer for coming on with me. Everybody out there for listening, we hope to see you at Front and Schiller Playground on October 29th. And for everybody at BCAP, where we believe a neighbor in need is a call to action. Thank you.
Thank you very much.